Yep, that's it. So, a couple years ago was my first time taking a train ride alone. And I'm from New York City, or not New York City, sorry, I lied to you, I lied to everyone. Not New York City, Long Island, but okay. Taking the train. I'm taking the train, and it's my first time, so I get on, I'm all nervous, and I'm alone, and I don't know what to do. So I just sit down, and I just, first seat. And that's when I knew that was a terrible mistake. Because this guy doesn't do anything, doesn't say anything, just goes like this. Thank you. He does like that, and I don't know what to do. I don't know if I'm supposed to like smack it or money. He's just a weird guy. He doesn't say anything, so he just looks forward again. Second thing he does, he goes into his bag and just pulls out a power drill and just starts going like, and looking at me, but there's no battery in it, so he's making the sound himself. So he's going like, I respect women.
What?
I said thank you, and I don't know why. He just says he respects, which is good. I mean, he had some bad qualities, bringing a power drill on a train, but you shouldn't have let this guy have a power drill. He was insane. So then I'm silent for a while, and then he starts up conversation. What are you going to the city for? And I'm like, I'm going to do stand-up. And he says, oh, that's perfect. Tell me a joke. I'd love to hear. I hate it when people ask me this question because I don't know what to say because this is kind of a story. And so I just say, oh, that chair right there, that's a pretty funny chair, right? Same reaction he had. And he says, oh, that's okay. Not everybody is funny. And he said, it's okay to be shy. And I didn't say it, but I thought it. It was confusing my shyness with, I think you might murder me? Because he has a power drill, I don't know. Dentists. I have this dentist, and he, I'll tell you, he has the best tasting fingers. Let me rephrase it. He has these cherry flavored gloves that he wears, and every time, you know, he's working in my mouth with his fingers, and he asks me, what, this is how he does his work. What flavor do you want, Max? And I say, cherry, please. So he puts on these gloves, he goes through the effort, and he starts working in my mouth like this. And I always feel obligated, like I don't want to be rude and not like lick his fingers because he put the cherry on for me. So I was like, okay, I'll give you a small nibble, but nothing much. That's not what he wanted. Usually half of me is thinking, when he has his fingers in my mouth, half of me is thinking, please let your fingers taste like that delicious cherry. And the other half of me is thinking, I don't want to taste your cherry fingers because he's my dentist and not my arborist. Yeah, that's... I'm always afraid of when I'm unconscious and he's doing oral surgery, that he'll have his fingers in my mouth doing his work and kind of reactionarily, not thinking I'll just like bite his fingers because I can't, like now when I'm awake, I can stop myself. But when I'm sleeping, it's everything lets loose. And I have to because I have nothing to stop it. Now, I'm gonna continue this, gonna do a little bit of an impression. Maybe it's something you haven't seen, maybe it has. That wasn't ticklish. Anyway, so you always see on nature documentaries like, oh, look at that, it's a beautiful swan. It's a beautiful swan, majestic and narrow. But you never see that there are pigeons. Pigeons get the short end of the stick, they really do. Now, I'm gonna do a little impression. Tell me if you feel something, if you connect with pigeons the way I do. Like, here we go. That's my pigeon impression. So pigeons, there's so much there. People just kind of, you know, like, oh, it's a pigeon. Have you ever looked a pigeon in the eyes? Not objectifying the pigeon like, oh, it's just a pigeon. Look it in the eyes, feel it. Now, I'm going to end tonight's set with a pun. You might not like it, but I love it. So here we go. I have an idea for a movie. It's about a priest who wants to quit smoking. It's called Holy Smokes.
Hey.
Thank you.